The Free Money Experiment of Wörgl. Austria in the 1920s. The First World War just ended, the Habsburg Empire broke up, and there's only a small country of a few million people left. And there's a lot of political and economic uncertainty. And of course, poverty. When the economy finally seemed to get better, the Great Depression that started at Wall Street in 1929 also hit Austria very hard. In the following years, unemployment jumped to record levels and many unemployed were left alone without any benefits from the federal government, which made social and economic misery even bigger, and the people became more receptive to populism and radical political parties and ideas. Helplessness was ubiquitous, but not so in Wörgl, a small town of 4,500 inhabitants in the Alpine Western Austrian region of Tyrol. The situation in Wörgl was dreadful. The city council was bankrupt, the local factory was closed, and many people emigrated because there was no hope for a better future. This was when Michael Unterguckenberger, the newly elected social democratic mayor of Wörgl, had an idea. Although he was a train driver, he was very interested in monetary theory and thought of it as a way to improve people's lives in the community. He also came across Silvio Gesell, a German economist who designed the so-called free money theory. Gesell believed that money enjoys an exorbitant privilege over goods and time because it does not rust or decay. Hence, he designed money that has incorporated devaluation, the so-called free money. This should, in his opinion, increase the velocity of circulation and improve economic stability. Faced with the enormous lack of money supply in Wörgl, Unterguckenberger convinced the other members of the city council to start an experiment, to create a new free money complementary currency and to issue their own money. Because the problem was not the lack of demand for goods or the lack of supply of labor, the only thing that was missing was the means of exchange, and that's where the new free money comes in. In July 1932, the city council started with building and renovating programs. Workers were paid with so-called Arbeitswertscheinen. Literally translated, this means work value notes, which were issued by the city council itself. The workers could buy their food in local shops with this complementary currency, which then paid the taxes or the debt at the city council, which then could finance new building programs. With the work value notes money, bridges, streets, hiking ways, and even a ski jumping hill were built. And also many old buildings were renovated. During the 13 and a half months of the experiment, over 100 people were employed. In just 1 year, unemployment decreased by 16%, whereas it raised by over 19% in the whole of Austria. Although there were much less Arbeitswertscheine or work value notes in circulation than Austrian shillings, the then normal currency in Austria, the complementary currency circulated much faster and hence was much more productive for the local economy. In just 13 months, over 5 million euros in today's purchasing power were invested in the community through the regional currency. The experiment of Wörgl was so successful that other councils also started issuing their own currency. Even the French Prime Minister visited the town because of its huge success with dealing with the economic crisis. In 1933, Wörgl's experiment was even mentioned in a debate in the US Senate. Unfortunately, in 1933, the Austrian National Bank saw its monopoly of printing money endangered and forbid the complementary currency in Wörgl, which ended the experiment only 13 and a half months after it started. However, the audacity of a mayor in a small province town in the Austrian Alps has shown that only with a little bit of economics, many things can be changed for the better. Thank you very much for your attention.